world, Chuck. I wish it were a full garage of cars, but what I actually do is I actually collect model cars. Not just the little matchbox, but the 318 size.
Well, Stephen, it's nice to have you here, and here is your $25,000 question. First question of the night. According to Duracell, which is not a size of their popular alkaline batteries? Is it AA, AAA, B, or C?
Well, I'd have to say I've had a lot of toys and games over my lifetime that have required batteries, and I happen to know for sure that it's not B.
So say it's B. Tony, accept or reject?
I am going to accept that answer, and I believe it exactly. I agree, B is the answer.
All right, $25,000. Is it B? Yeah. $25,000. Going to keep it. Want to move on?
Chuck, it's fourth down and 80 yards, and we're going to keep it and keep on going. Let's go.
All right, here we go. All right, Linda, how are you?
I'm great, Chuck. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. That was lunch with Oprah.
It was absolutely wonderful.
Was it?
Yeah.
What did you do? You didn't do what you had to talk.
Well, yeah, I did. Actually, I was selected to appear as a guest on her book club show a couple of months back. So that included a trip to Chicago, an appearance on her show, as well as a meal afterwards.
Well, it's nice to have you here, Linda. Good luck to you tonight. And here is your $50,000 question. What does Scott's Miracle-Gro help grow? Your hair, your fingernails, your plants, your puppy.
Well, Chuck, my thumb is not green, but I do know that the answer would be your plants.
Plants. Tony, accept or reject?
Chuck, I'm going to accept that answer.
Here we go. Is it your plants for $50,000?
We got a first down, but we're not in the end zone. We're going to keep on moving.
Here we go. Hi, Bill.
Hey, Chuck. How you doing?
I'm fine. Thanks. Bill, really want to win tonight, I suppose.
Yeah, I could use the money.
What are your plans for it?
Well, I just bought a house by the beach, and it's sort of like a money pit. So the money's already spent.
Okay. Well, Bill, good luck to you, and here is your $75,000 question. Francis Ford Coppola, Steven Seagal, and the Smothers Brothers all have their names on labels for which of these products? Neckties, tomato sauce, bed sheets, wine, men's cologne.
I'm not 100% sure, but I believe, no, I am sure, it's wine.
Bill went from I'm not 100% sure to he's absolutely sure.
Well, I'll tell you what, I believe it is wine also. So I'm going to go right with you, and it's wine.
$75,000. Is it wine? It is. Good choice. Good choice. We're moving now, Tony.
Hey, Chuck. And I'll keep using that football terminology. I think we had a holding penalty. I was kind of a little concerned. So we need to get more yardage. We're going to keep on going.
Keep on going. $100,000. It's all on your shoulders, May. Well, not all. Tony's got a little responsibility, too. Why are you such a late bloomer? What happened to you?
I'm an early bloomer.
An early bloomer. I'm sorry. You are. I'm the late bloomer. You're the early one.
It's because I started college when I was 14.
You were 14?
Yeah.
Good night. How was that?
It was different.
It
was a big culture shock. I went to a really small private Christian high school, and then public college. It was very different.
I'll bet. Well, welcome to the show, May.
Thank
Glad
you.
You're here. Here is your $100,000 question. Good luck. What is the name of Microsoft's online and CD-ROM encyclopedia? Is it Explorer, Inquire, Encarta, Intelligentsia, Knowledge Master?
Okay, well, I don't know for, I know for sure that Encarta is an encyclopedia. That is a CD-ROM, so I'm going to guess that. I don't know for sure that's made by Microsoft, but.
Encarta is your answer?
I know that Encarta is an encyclopedia.
Accept or reject, Tony?
Actually, I think it's either Explorer and Carter. I'm going to have to take a chance on this one. I'm a little miffed at this one. I'm going to have to take a chance that In Carter is correct.
So you go along with her?
Go along with her.
$100,000. In Carter. Four questions away from $2 million.
That's all?
That's it. All
right,
four
then.
Questions away. They're a little harder this time.
Oh, okay.
Each question has four correct answers instead of one. You'll be depending on your other players to come up with those answers. And my question to you is, do you want to keep your $100,000 and leave now, or do you want to continue on and try out for the $200,000? Before you answer,
okay,
let me tell you what the category is for the $200,000 question. It's TV favorites.
TV favorites.
You want to keep that $100,000 or do you feel the need?
We're going to keep on going.
Keep on going. Here we go. Well, that's the sound of the Terminator. It gives one player a chance to eliminate another player and take his or her money by challenging them to a one-question showdown, or they can keep the group the way it is. But to sweeten the pot, I'm going to give the challenger $10,000 to play the showdown, win or lose. And I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to come right back and activate that Terminator right after this. Stay with us.
Good morning.
The way that you are, it's just the way that you talk, like it ain't no thing, and every single day is just a fling.
Get the shave of your life. Mach 3. It's so effortless. You take one stroke, it takes three. The closest shave in fewer strokes with less irritation. Mach 3 from Gillette.
Express Makeup 3-in-1 from Maybelline. It glides on liquid smooth, dots on to conceal, finishes powder light. Express Makeup 3-in-1.
It's makeup made simple.
Maybe she's born with it.
Not one of these single-ingredient products is FDA-approved to relieve all your migraine symptoms. But Excedrin Migraine is. In fact, now it's FDA-approved to relieve your complete migraine. Head pain, sensitivity to light, sound, even nausea. With a formula that has two proven pain relievers, plus an enhancer to make them work even better on all your symptoms.
For a free Excedrin Migraine offer, see the Sunday's paper.
Former occupation,
sumo wrestler. What's so funny?
You're just a little guy. What happened?
This, it tastes too good. I didn't know it wasn't regular cola.
I don't need to see that. This is good.
Try Pepsi One. A breakthrough sweetener makes it taste more like a regular.
Have you ever thought about being a jockey?
You're a funny lady.
Too good to be one calorie, but it is.
Prepare yourself, because Fox Wednesday, the emotional goodbyes begin. First.
You're leaving because of me?
It's too late.
Why is it too late?
Just three episodes left, all new 90210. Then.
You dream about leaving until the moment comes.
This is good.
I wish I could stay.
Why are you giving up on this so easily?
Just two episodes left, all new Party of Five. It all starts at 8, 7 Central tomorrow on Fox.
Travel provided by Priceline.com, where you name the price and save on airline tickets, hotel rooms, mortgages, new cars, and more. Visit Priceline on the internet or call 1-800-PRICELINE.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. Well, as I said, we're going to activate the Terminator, see who's going to stay, and see who may go. Let's activate it now. Linda. Linda, the Terminator has chosen you. Is there anyone here that you would like to call out and challenge to a one-question showdown? I will give you $10,000, win or lose.
Steven.
Steven, you're on, buddy. Let's rock. Steven, you've been challenged. You'll be on this side. And Linda, you'll be here. Here is your $10,000. But I ask you one question. Remember, you can buzz in any time you think you know the answer. The winner will take the loser's share of the pot and play for $80,000. The loser will be out of the game. Good luck to both of you. Linda, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Steven, are you ready? Here we go. What company produces the Hungry Man line of frozen foods? Yes, Linda.
Swanson.
You've got it. Got you, Steven. Thank you, buddy. Woo. Get your money? Got your money? Okay. Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here is your $200,000 question. Good luck. I said it was TV favorites. Which four of the following six TV favorites have appeared the most times on the cover of TV Guide? Bill Cosby, Lucille Ball, Mary Tyler Moore, Roseanne, Bob Barker, Johnny Carson. All right, that little noise means you get a freebie. That's good to take away one wrong answer for the rest of the game. You can use it now or you can use it later, Tony. It's up to you.
I'm gonna use it now.
Use it now,
yep,
okay?
I'm gonna use it now. I don't wanna take any chances.
All righty, so that took away Roseanne. You're left with five answers. Four of those are correct, one is incorrect. And Linda, we'll start with you. Give me a correct answer, please.
As far as I'm concerned, she was the queen of television. I'm gonna say Lucille Ball.
That is one. Bill.
I believe Bill Cosby.
That's two. May.
I'm gonna say Mary Tyler Moore.
That's three. What do you think, Tony?
I'm gonna go with Johnny Carson.
Johnny Carson is four. Now, since you're the captain, you can change anyone you want or leave them the way they are. It's up to you.
$200,000. I'm gonna go with it.
Gonna go with it?
Go with him.
All right. They're all set in place. Good luck. Here we go. Let's see what happens. Is Lucille Ball a correct answer? Three away. Bill Cosby. Yes, sir. Mary Tyler Moore. I don't know how sure you are of your answer. By the way, I failed to mention, you played with Dallas.
Yes,
you?
Most certainly.
Yeah, you did.
Had America's
great,
team.
Had a great career with them, too. And yeah, you have a great ring on. Let me see your ring while I show this money. Look at this. Can you see this on this camera? Huh? Is that a cool ring? It's a lot bigger than mine. I had this little dinky when I had forgot it tonight. But man, that's got four diamonds in it, doesn't it? No, they're more than that.
It's about 30 of them, Chuck.
Can't stand it. I'm standing here with a measly 20 grand.
Measly?
Well, I'm going to offer you this $20,000 for Johnny Carson. It's up to you. If you don't want to keep that 20, you can give it back to me, and you can go for the money.
Well, it's hard to go against Bob Barker over here, but old Johnny Carson's an icon. I got to go with Johnny Carson.
Give me the money back for $200,000. Everybody's got a smile on their face. Is it Johnny Carson? Linda has 90 because she has that 10,000 from the thermometer that she won. So now, Tony, here we go again. Want to keep the 200,000? You want to risk it? Do you feel the need? Let me give you the category of the $500,000 question. Best-selling cars. It's a tough decision. It's a lot of money. I agree. It's a lot of money.
You know
it's
something?
A tough decision.
We're going to go for it.
You're going to go for the $500,000. All right, that's the sound of the Terminator, and we're going to activate it right after this break. Stay with us.
Now,
now there's a Chevy Venture with flip and fold seats and a built-in entertainment system.
I knew I should have taken a left turn at Albuquerque.
Introducing the Warner Brothers Edition from Chevy Venture, the most versatile minivan ever. Give us a call. Chevy Venture. We'll be there.
Get $1,500 cash back on any Chevy Venture model, including the popular Venture LS. See your Chevy dealer today.
Someday, at a job interview, they'll ask, do you work well under pressure? Try not to laugh. In here, it's always Friday.
Boom, 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 boom.
And in here, Friday's famous Jack Grill entrees are getting something new. Your favorite cuts of meat with golden shrimp.
Boom, 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 boom.
Yeah. Fox Thursday, two phenomenal new specials. First, shocking new evidence of the afterlife, the most bizarre footage ever, ghosts, fact or fiction. Then, from top secret files and new videos, the most incredible UFO footage. UFOs, best evidence ever. Two all-new specials starting at 8, 7 Central, Fox Thursday.
This month, greed becomes super greed, and everything's doubled. The intensity, the drama, and a $4 million jackpot. Super Greed, Fox Friday at 9.
Tablecloths, and everything else to enjoy the season at IKEA's Spring Forward event. Fly swatters, and everything else for the season at IKEA's Spring Forward event.
Laurel Lane's one of our big problem areas right now. Everyone's sharing the same cable line for the internet. They slow each other down, and they get a little nuts.
So how long were you on the internet tonight?
20 minutes.
20 hours! 20 hours!
Everybody got a computer. That was okay. Everybody wanted to get on the internet. That was okay. Everybody wanted to get on the internet at the same time.
Logo! Logo!
Not a good thing.
The internet is, once again, your friend. Call now for free installation and free modem.
The mom approved V6 seven passenger enormously helpful Odyssey from Honda. It's one big happy minivan.
It's late, and you're tired. Midnight's no time to have to return a movie, so now Blockbuster lets you keep them longer. 12 hours longer. They're not due back till noon, 'cause it's late, and you're tired.
50 geniuses compete in the most intense game show ever. And they're all under 12. The Battle of the Child Geniuses in 2 weeks on Fox.
All right, we're back. And let's activate the Terminator now. May. The Terminator has chosen you. Is there anyone here that you would like to call out and challenge for their portion?
I think I'm going to challenge Linda because she has the most money.
Challenge Linda. She's got all the money. Okay, here we go. Linda, you've been challenged. You'll be here on this side. May, you're the challenger. Here's your $10,000.
Yep.
All right. I'm going to ask you one question. Remember, you can buzz in anytime you think you know the answer. The winner will take the loser's share of the pot and play for $300,000, May. The loser is out of the game. Good luck to both of you. Are you ready, May?
Yes.
Are you ready, Linda?
I'm ready.
Here's your question. What card game has variations such as stud, high-low? Linda?
Poker.
You're exactly right. You got it. But you got your $10,000. Thank you for playing. Right over this way. Woo! playing for $300,000. Bill's playing for $100,000. Tony's playing for $100,000. I wish you the best of luck. I'd love to give you this money. And here is your $500,000 question. Good luck to you. I said it was best-selling cars. According to an article in the March 14th, 2000 Wall Street Journal, which four of the following seven automobile companies and their affiliates have the highest global market share? General Motors, Ford, Honda, Volkswagen, Hyundai, Toyota, BMW. Okay, Linda, give me the first answer.
Because the question speaks to global market share, I'm going to go with BMW.
BMW, that's one. Bill?
For the same reasons, I like Honda very much.
It's two. Tony?
I'm going to go with Toyota.
That's three. Now, you can answer the next question, or you can pass it on to one of your players. It's up to you. Or you can give me the, I'm saying, give me the right answer, the fourth answer. I'll get this out.
I'm gonna pass it on to Linda.
Linda, you have the fourth answer.
That's tough. I'm torn, but I'm gonna say General Motors.
General Motors. All right, now Tony, you can change one answer if you like, or you can keep them the way they are. It's up to you. As captain, that's your prerogative.
I'm not absolutely sure on this General Motors.
It's a big decision. It's a lot of money.
Yeah, I like the things Volkswagen over General Motors. I'm going to make that switch from General Motors to Volkswagen.
General Motors to Volkswagen. Those are your four answers in place. We'll start now. Toyota. Correct, that's one. Changed from General Motors to Volkswagen. Honda. I am so sorry, everybody, Tony included. I am really sorry. General Motors and Ford are probably the largest two car makers in the world, and they service the entire world. BMW is not even close, and neither is Honda. Not even close. Boy, you were... Well, Linda's going to take home the only money here. She's got $10,000, and we congratulate her for that. Thank you so much for playing the game.
Thank
it was
you.
Very nice meeting you, Tony.
My pleasure to meet
very
you.
Very nice meeting you. And Bill, thanks for playing the game.
My pleasure.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet our next group.
Jeff Sidman.
Simi Valley, California, sixth grade teacher, and my mom thinks I'm a star.
Michael Ebo.
St. Martinville, Louisiana, software engineer, and I'm a member of the royal family.
Carrie Pierce.
Plano, Texas, mom and wife, and in my spare time, I build human pyramids.
Greg Reed.
New York City, trademark attorney, and I was initially attracted to this game show.
Cinnamon Baldwin.
New Orleans, Louisiana, grant writer. My parents love watching television.
Andrew Mitchell.
Las Vegas, Nevada, chiropractor, and I once treated an eagle.
Let's get started by asking our qualifying question, and here is your question. According to NFL statistics, what was the average weight in pounds of an NFL player at the start of the 1999 season? Your time starts now. Okay, all your answers are locked in. The correct answer is 244 pounds. That's a lot of beef, isn't it? All right, let's see who's going to lead this group. Cinnamon, 245 pounds right over here. You're the leader. You're going to be the captain. Who's next? That would be you, Jeff, position number one. Congratulations to you. Who is next? It's going to be you, Michael, 225, right over here, number two. Who's next? It's going to be you, Andrew, 220. You're in the third position between Greg and Carrie. One will be playing for over $2 million. The other will go back into the contestant pool. Who's going to play? It's going to be you, Greg. Sorry, Carrie. We'll see you again sometime. And Greg, you're in position number one, ladies and gentlemen. This is your next group for greed. All right. Well, remember, any time a group misses a question, they lose everything. And Cinnamon, I know you know the rules, right? Ready to play?
Yes, we're
all right,
ready to play.
Let's play greed. Hi, Greg.
Hi, Chuck.
Greg, what was your initial attraction to the show?
Well, Chuck, my first initial is G. My last name is Reed. Put it together, you got greed.
Oh, G. Reed. Oh, you got your license. Is that your real license plate?
Real license plate.
Oh, I want one of those.
Yeah. Well, see what I could do.
I'll tell you what. Here is your $25,000 question.
Okay.
Good luck to you. Which of the following is a real American town named after a popular game show? Truth or Consequences, New Mexico. Greed, Iowa. Family Feud, Arkansas. Press Your Luck, Nevada.
Well, if there was a city named Greed, I would love to live there. But I know for a fact the answer is Truth or Consequences, New Mexico.
What is that for a fact you said, Cinnamon? You accept or reject?
I accept. I've been there, so...
Really?
Yes.
I've never been there. Well, Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, is that correct? For $25,000. Yeah, that's it. You got $25,000. 50's the next check. We'll come back to see how they do right after this. Stay with us.
Gladiator. Rated R. Starts Friday, May 5th.
Hey, man, check it out.
Hey, how'd you do that?
Do what?
Trick out the door.
The redesigned three-door coupe from Saturn. It just might turn a few heads.
Do you think your fridge can hold all that?
It's always a challenge.
Well, why not get a bigger one at Sears? The only store that carries the top six brand names.
It'd have to be a really good price.
Oh, it is. Right now, you'll save $100 on a Kenmore top mount refrigerator with a built-in ice maker. It's only $4.99.
Sounds great.
And when you buy any home appliance over $3.99, Sears will deliver it for free.
So I'll be able to keep lots of crisp, green stuff, right?
Lots. Hurry, sale ends Friday. Sears, the good life at a great price, guaranteed.
Some kids think smoking weed makes you cool. What about those who think you already are?
Our technology goes to China and back before you can blink an eye.
It's like totally breakthrough.
But didn't two kids in Sweden already invent virtual freeze tag?
I'm getting that rash again.
Freak.
Wouldn't it be smarter to go to hotjobs.com and join forces with a styling company on the verge of an IPO?
Yeah, IPO.
Now
IPO.
You're feeling it. And did I mention I have jobs at over 5,000 companies worldwide at my fingertip?
Hotjobs.com, ow! The hottest hand on the web.
IPO.
Dude, decaf.
IPO.
Sunday, the Simpsons turn spring break upside down.
Party!
It's the ultimate party with guest star Kid Rock on a wild new Simpsons. Then, to become a rollerblade pro, Malcolm will learn from the best. His dad?
In street hockey, not clown school.
Malcolm after the Simpsons, all new starting at 8, Fox Sunday.
Greed, the show that's given away over $10 million.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. Well, you got $25,000, Cinnamon. You want to keep that or you want to risk it?
Let's go.
Let's go, she says. Right to Andrew. How are you, Andrew?
I'm doing great, Chuck. Thank you.
Andrew, you're a chiropractor. I know you said you treated an eagle. Are you also a vet?
Funny you ask that. Recently, I had the opportunity to treat one of the members of the music group, the Eagles, when they played in Las Vegas.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay, Andrew, here is your $50,000 question. What animal is the official mascot of the frozen treat called the Klondike Bar? Is it a seal, a polar bear, a whale, or a penguin?
Well, Chuck, I have eaten these on occasion, and I know I'm almost 100% it's a polar bear.
It says polar bear. Cinnamon, you accept or reject?
I accept it.
Yeah, she's accepting it. $50,000. Is it polar bear? Yes. Here we go again, Cinnamon. Keep it.
Let's go.
Moving on. Hi, Michael. How you doing?
Pretty good, Chuck.
What is this royal family you're talking about, Michael?
Well, Chuck, my father and brother-in-law were kings.
Were they?
My two sisters and my niece were queens. My daughter is a princess. And this year, I'm the king of the Mardi Gras in my hometown in Louisiana.
Is that right? Well, yes, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah. Nice to have you here, Michael.
Thank you.
Good luck to you. And here is your $75,000 question. According to the American Psychiatric Association, what is the difference between a psychiatrist and a psychologist? The length of the therapy session, a medical degree, their age, their experience, their ability to conduct group sessions.
I'm not sure about this question, Chuck, but I would think it's a medical degree.
He says a medical degree separates the two.
He's right. I'm going to accept.
She's going to accept. She says he's right. $75,000. Is it a medical degree? You got it. Nicely done, Michael. And Captain. Well, Cinnamon, $75,000 is next. What are you
going
to do?
We're
going
to keep going.
Keep on going. Hi, Jeff.
Hi, Chuck.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
You said your mom thinks you're a star in the opening. What did you mean by that, or what did you mean by that?
Well, I'm a huge fan of astronomy, and I go out looking at the stars all the time, and she knows this, so this last Christmas, she called up the International Star Registry and had a star named after her.
You can do that?
Yeah. If you look up in the constellation Perseus, you'll see Jeffrey Allen Sidman's star.
Wow. Well, that's incredible. I've never met a real star.
I haven't.
Congratulations, Jeff.
Well, thank you.
And here is your $100,000 question. Good luck. By law, during which 2 months of the year do most Americans adjust their clocks for daylight savings time? January and July, February and June, April and October, May and November, April and December.
You know what? I'm absolutely certain on this, that it is April and October.
Absolutely certain, he says.
I'm going to accept.
You feel confident with that?
I feel very confident.
Yeah? Okay. $100,000. April and October. Is that correct? It is. Congratulations. Yeah, these are not easy. You guys are breezing through this stuff. Well, questions get a little harder this time. Each question has 4 correct answers. I know you know that. Now, of course, I've got to ask you whether you want to keep the $100,000 or whether you want to risk it. Before you answer, let me tell you what the category is. The category for the $200,000 question is money, money, money. So do you want to keep that $100,000 or do you feel the need?
Feel the need for greed.
You do. Gonna go. Here we go. All right, That's the sound of the Terminator. We're going to come right back to play it right after this. Stay with us.
How come Joe Namath was more popular than Johnny Unitas? Both were great quarterbacks. Both jerseys hang in the Hall of Fame. But then, only one quarterback was ever seen on the sidelines wearing a full-length mink coat. The all-new Mitsubishi Montero. Nicely equipped at $31,000. Toughness meets style.
What if Hollywood put an X-File on the silver screen?
Who do you see playing you in the movie?
How about Richard Gere?
With Gary Shandling as Mulder and Taya Leone as Scully.
Mulder!
Written and directed by David Duchovny.
You cigarette-smoking mackerel snapper.
The X-Files, all new at 9, 8 Central, Fox Sunday.
This is a celebration of performance, athletic performance, and Pontiac performance. As an official sponsor of the 2000 U.S. Olympic team, Pontiac invites you to the Pontiac Performance Experience. Get 1,000 cash back or 0% APR financing on a 2000 Grand Prix. You'll also get a chance to win a trip to see the 2000 U.S. Olympic team compete in Sydney. Just log on to Pontiac.com or call to enter and you could be there. Hey, your opportunity to experience exciting performance is here.
Vases and everything for the season at IKEA's Spring Forward event.
You know, I really think your dad is starting to warm up to me.
Yeah.
Hey, Mr. Miller.
Patio umbrellas and everything else to enjoy the season at IKEA's Spring Forward event.
There is a place of magic and mystery, a land of wonder and delight, where the native treasures come alive. Flavors that were separate become entwined. Tastes that were ordinary become spectacular. Watch as the beauty unfolds before you. Coco's, what more could you want?
On Fox 11 News, a wild scare on Alaska Airlines. A gun fires in the baggage compartment, tearing into the passenger cabin. Then, was it revenge by taggers? Police search for a Southland man's killers. Plus, terror at a tourist attraction as an elephant suddenly goes on a deadly rampage. On Fox 11 News at 10.
Fox Monday, an all-new That 70s Show turns to religion.
I get high on G-O-D.
Virgin.
Then, how do you avoid a traffic ticket? Have a good plan.
What seems to be the problem, officer?
An all-new Titus. Turn it up at 8, 7 Central, Fox Monday.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. We're going to find out who's going to go and who's going to stay. Let's activate the Terminator now. Jeff. Terminator's chosen you, Jeff. Is there anyone here you'd like to call out for $10,000, win or lose?
Oh, yeah, there is. I can't really read his name down here at the end, and I forgot it, but...
Come on, Greg?
Greg, down there.
Ooh,
at the end.
I feel a little tension here. Okay, Greg, come on. Greg, your challenge. You'll be on this side. Jeff, you'll be on this side over here.
Seems a little too anxious to get me.
Yeah, boy, he seems a little anxious, doesn't he? Here's your $10,000, Jeff.
Thank you very much.
Okie dokie. I'm going to ask you one question. Remember, you can buzz in anytime you think you know the answer. The winner will take the loser's share of the pot and play for $80,000. The loser will be out of the game. Good luck to both of you. Greg, are you ready?
I'm ready, Jeff. Thanks.
Jeff, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Here is your question. What American city shares its name with Kraft's best-selling cream cheese? Greg.
Philadelphia.
That's exactly right. Boy, he just got under the wire. Thanks for playing the game, Jeff. You got your $10,000 right over here. Greg. Congratulations. Well, sometimes it doesn't always work out the way you think it's going to work out, but you never know what's going to happen. Okay, I said the category was money, money, money. Here is your $200,000 question. Which four of the following six structures currently appear on the back of United States paper currency? White House, Lincoln Memorial, U.S. Capitol, U.S. Treasury, Washington Monument, Statue of Liberty. Okay, well, you've earned a freebie. You can use this to take away one wrong answer anytime during the show, anytime during the game, actually. You can use it now, you can use it later. What are you going to do?
We're going to wait.
You're going to wait. Okay, seem pretty confident. Here we go. Give me an answer, Greg.
I'm not sure what bill it's on, but I am pretty close to 100% sure that I've seen the White House on a bill.
That's one. Andrew.
I think I'm going to have to go, and I'm not sure, but the U.S. Capitol.
That's two. Michael.
I'm not sure, but I think I've seen the Lincoln Memorial on a bill.
That's three. Last one's up to you, Cinnamon.
No, it's not the Statue of Liberty. I'm going to say the Washington Monument.
Say the Washington Monument. All right, now you can take a look at all four of those. Make sure that's what you want to keep. You can change any one that you want, or you can keep them the way they are.
I'll stay with it.
You're going to stay with it. Okay, here we go. Is the White House correct? It is. It's on the back of the $20 bill. The Lincoln Memorial. And it's on the back of the $5 bill. The U.S. Capitol. It's on the back of the $50 bill. Well, well, well. Here we are. Got U.S. Treasury, Statue of Liberty, and you chose the Washington Monument. So those are the three. And I don't know how confident you are. But here's $20,000 to make you feel a little bit better, just in case you want to stop here and take your money. I don't want to take the chance on that answer, the Washington Monument. I'm going to give you the money. You can hold it, weigh it, and decide what you want to do. I will be happy to take it back if you want to go for it. And if you don't, we'll all understand. It's up to you.
We're going to go.
You got to go? Let me have my money. For $200,000, is the Washington Monument on the back of any paper currency in the United States? As a matter of fact, if you look at this, see that FV? It was the freebie. It would have been the one being thrown out. It was the U.S. Treasury. You knew the Statue of Liberty was no one. You'd have had it if you'd used your freebie. Well, I'm so sorry. Thank you. All right, we're going to come right back right after this with a new team. Stay with us.
Next on Fox 11 News, Elian Gonzalez on the move again as Janet Reno faces tough questions about the raid on the home of his Miami relatives. A surprising technicality that may prevent a Southland woman from becoming a U.S. citizen. And Bruce Willis becomes a friend for charity.
Your new berry, a new grape. So bold, it's fierce.
I think I'm gonna need some more fierce.
Express Makeup 3-in-1 from Maybelline. It glides on liquid smooth, dots on to conceal, finishes powder light. Express Makeup 3-in-1.
It's makeup made simple.
Maybe she's born with it.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
This is the revolutionary cross-action toothbrush. Its unique patented crisscross bristles penetrate to lift out and sweep away more plaque than today's leading brushes for the cleanest, healthy teeth possible. The cross-action from Oral-B.
How come Joe Namath was more popular than Johnny Unitas? Both were great quarterbacks. Both jerseys hang in the Hall of Fame. But then, only one quarterback was ever seen on the sidelines wearing a full-length mink coat. The all-new Mitsubishi Montero. Nicely equipped at $31,000. Toughness meets style.
Travel provided by Priceline.com, where you name the price and save on airline tickets, hotel rooms, mortgages, new cars, and more. Visit Priceline on the internet or call 1-800-PRICELINE.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. Let's meet our next player.
J.B. Blocker.
I'm from the great city of Dallas. I'm a biochemist, but they call me the caffeine cowboy.
Eddie Robinson.
Bronx, New York, personal security. And I have something in common with Kevin Costner.
Helene Coustan.
New York, New York, publicist, and I got lucky in a bar.
Dave Parker.
Venice, California, videotape editor, and I've spent a lot of time in cemeteries.
Rona Coe.
Milpitas, California, wife and mother, and I love to talk with my hands.
Tracy Bernard.
Minneapolis, Minnesota, wife and mother, and I have something in common with Monica Lewinsky.
Well, welcome to the show. I'm kind of hoping you all make it because I got to hear these stories. All right, let's get started by asking our qualified question, and here is your question. In terms of millions, how many pounds of ground beef does Taco Bell use each year? Your time starts now. Answers are locked in. Here are the correct answer. Here is the correct answer. They use 300 million pounds each year. All right. Who's going to lead this group? 250. Rona, you got it. You're going to be the captain over here, so come on over. Congratulations. Who's our next player? 500. Helene, we get to hear your story. You're in position number one. And who is our next player? Dave, with 70, you made it. Right over here, sir. And who is next? JB, 45, you're part of the group. It's down to Eddie and Tracy. One will be playing for a possible $2 million. The other will be back into the contestant pool. Who's going to play? It's going to be you, Tracy. Congratulations, Eddie. Thank you very much. And ladies and gentlemen, this is your next group for Greed. Well, remember any time a group misses a question, they lose everything. You remember that, don't you? Okay, Rona, how you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good today.
All right, well, you know the rules. Let's play Greed. Hi, Tracy, how are you?
Hi, good.
Good. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Tracy, what do you have in common with Monica Lewinsky?
Only one thing.
Yes?
And that is I was a White House intern.
When was that?
It was during the same time Monica was there, 96.
Well, it's nice to have you here, Tracy.
Thank you very much.
Here is your $25,000 question. Good luck. Tracy. If your daughter comes home and tells you she's dating a thespian, who is she seeing? A shot putter, a speech therapist, an actor, or an architect?
Chuck, I am extremely certain that that's an actor.
An actor? What do you think, Rona?
I am extremely certain also, and I accept that answer, Chuck.
All right, $25,000. Is it an actor? Oh, yeah. Well, you want to keep that 25? You want to risk it?
Oh, we're going to risk it and go for it.
Okay. Hi, JB. How you doing?
Great. How about you?
Good. Well, caffeine cowboy, what's that all about?
Well, I'm an exceptional coffee expert.
Really? What's the best coffee you've ever tasted in your life?
Some that I've roasted, actually.
Oh, you roast your own?
Yeah.
Well, send me some, JG.
That'd be great.
Here's your $50,000 question, JB. AP, UPI, and Reuters are three of the world's largest what? News services, plumbing services, insurance companies, long-distance phone companies.
I don't know them as an insurance company,
nor
as a long-distance carrier because I'm inundated with the commercials. I am fairly certain that it's new service.
New services. Accept or reject?
I absolutely accept that answer, Chuck.
He says that's it. $50,000. Are they news services? They are. There you go. Now. Gonna keep that money? Move right on. Hi, Dave.
How you doing?
How come you spend so much time in cemeteries, Dave?
I was a groundskeeper for a cemetery for a while.
What's that? Is it a little spooky at night?
Actually, you don't really stay at late. You just mow the grass, you get a nice tan, and you dig a big hole every once in a while.
Oh. It's kind of the order of things, I guess. Okay. It's kind of how life goes. Yeah. Mow the grass, get a good tan, and somebody digs a hole for you.
Exactly.
That's it. Yeah. Okay. Well, Dave, here is your $75,000 question. Good luck. According to the Joy of Cooking cookbook, which of the following is not found in a classic Reuben sandwich? Corned beef, sliced tomato, Russian dressing, sauerkraut, Swiss cheese.
I've eaten a lot of Reubens. Shouldn't have a tomato in there.
Says no tomato, Ronan.
That answer.
Well, you guys are all over these. $75,000. Is it tomato? That's right. Yeah, 75. Gonna move on?
We have a strong team. We gotta go for it.
All right. We've been waiting for you, Helen. Helene. It's Helene, right?
Helene.
Yeah. How are you?
Good.
Now, you got lucky in a bar. Boy, between Monica Lewinsky and getting lucky in a bar, I don't know where to start. Tell me that story.
That story is about how I met my husband. Randomly, he was working as a bartender, and I was waiting for a friend at a bar, and she was extremely late, and we struck up conversation, and end of the story is we ended up getting married.
How long?
We got married in September.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
That's nice to have you.
Thank you.
I'd like to hear those happy stories. Yeah. Well, Helene, good luck to you, and here is your $100,000 question. The names of how many American states begin with the letter M? 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. How many states begin with the letter M? Well, I can see the wheels turn.
I believe the answer is 4.
He thinks it's 4, Ronan. You accept or reject?
I'm going to go with Helene's answer. We're going to go with 4.
Go with 4. Mm-hmm. All right. The names of how many American states begin with the name of M, or the letter M? Is it 4? No, it's not. As a matter of fact, it's 8. 8 is the correct answer. You were only halfway there. Oh, that's too tough. I'm telling you. I know you probably know them now, but let me give you the list. It's Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, and Montana. That's all the time we have for tonight. We're going to see you this Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, 8 Central, right here on Fox. See you here. Bye-bye.
Fox 11 News is next. Tonight, new trouble for Todd Marinovich. We'll tell you why the former USC football star has been arrested again. A money manager accused of stealing millions of dollars from some of Hollywood's biggest stars faces a judge. A terrifying attack as an elephant goes on a deadly rampage at an animal park. And find out about plans to turn the O.J. Simpson case into a TV miniseries. You're seconds away from Fox 11 News.
The Southland's choice for news. Fox 11 News at 10.
A pro athlete is in trouble with the law, and this time it hits close to home. LA Avenger player and former USC football star Todd Marinovich arrested on suspicion of felony sexual assault. Good evening, everybody. I'm John Beard.
And I'm Christine Devine.
An interesting day, to say the least, for...